The Strawberry Festival Committee has worked very hard to bring you this show this year. It's the 31st year. We have lots of things for everybody to do. And I think we're going to have the official opening with our town crier, Marcel Bossy.
Hoyet! 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 My lords! Ladies! Officers of the Crown and distinguished guests, now hear ye this. This day we observe the opening of the 31st annual Richard Stovall Strawberry Festival. From its humble beginnings as a magic and illusionist spectacular, this annual community event has evolved into today's tribute to our community, country close to the city. Over the years, it's legions of volunteers, without whom, just like the 2015 Pan Am and Para Pan Am Games, this festival would not have been possible, have attracted vendors, sponsors, visitors, and most importantly, the goodwill of the people, which has made our annual summer celebration into a must-attend extravaganza. Furthermore, all year requested, nay, commanded, to commemorate the 148th anniversary of the creation of our great dominion. Let it be known that in celebration there shall be pyrotechnics and other displays of a celebratory nature for all to enjoy on Wednesday next. May the weather gods oblige and convey to us nothing but sunny, sultry summer days. However, kindly remember that should the heavens open, it's just Richard Stovall's fiscally responsible free street cleaning in action. So proclaimed on this 26th day of June in the year of our Lord, 2115. God grace Stovall. God bless you all. And may God save Elizabeth, our gracious queen.
Thank you to our town crier. So I'd like to now welcome to the stage Mr. Paul Calandra. He's our local member of parliament. Thank you.
Well, thank you again. Again, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you. I'm not going to talk, but that's okay. It's a pleasure to be here. Let me welcome you and congratulate the Strawberry Festival team. I know how hard they work all year, so I want to congratulate them for bringing this this festival year in and year out to our community. This is an opportunity also for me to just remind everybody that part of the Strawberry Festival is a celebration of Canada. And Canada, of course, as you know, I don't have to tell you, is the best country in the world in which to live. Every year, millions of people, if given the option, would choose to come and live in Canada. And now Canada is stronger, safer, more prosperous than it has ever been before, and it is because of your hard work. So on July 1st, think back, think of 148 great years, think of why this country is the greatest country in the world in which to live, and be grateful that you are the lucky ones who get to live in this country. So have a great Canada Day and a great Strawberry Festival, and as the town crier said, God bless Canada and God bless Stovall.
Thanks very much. I'd like to now welcome to the stage Dr. Helena Jaksik, who's our member of provincial parliament.
thank you so much. Well, I've been coming here so many years that, of course, I was over in the tent over there. I thought we were going to celebrate there as we normally do. I just want to say what a wonderful day for Stovall, and what fun to combine everything with the Pan Am Games, the Strawberry Festival, Canada Day, and I truly think, as I look around, we have the most amazing community. I asked some of the organizers of the Pan Am Games how they felt. Where was Stovall in the scheme of things? 130 communities have welcomed the torch. And I was told this was absolutely one of the best celebrations. And of course, why wouldn't it be? Stovall has the most amazing spirit. Everybody, happy Canada Day. Enjoy the Strawberry Festival. And know that you live in one of the very best parts of one of the best provinces, the best country in the whole world. Thank you so much.
And now I'd like to welcome to the stage Mayor Altman. Thank you.
I'm a little shorter. So on behalf of the municipality of Wishart Stovall, I'd like to congratulate the Strawberry Festival for another very, very, very good year. This is an exceptional job again by the Strawberry Festival. I'd also like to introduce, we have in the audience here, Councillor Rick Upton, Councillor Hugo Kroon, Councillor Moore Smith, and Councillor Rob Hargrave. So four of our councillors are here with us tonight. So again, I want you all to enjoy the Strawberry Festival. The volunteers, again, these are volunteers that have put together the largest festival for the municipality, bringing in about 30,000 people to visit over the weekend. So again, I'd like to give them a large round of applause for the work well done. It's exemplary. And again, I want you all to enjoy it. We were up this morning at 5:30 this morning picking berries, so you have fresh berries in the trailer. The ladies were up, they were cutting, they were peeling, everything is ready to go. So have the berries, enjoy, shop local, farm local, and enjoy the Strawberry Festival. Happy Canada Day. Thank you.
Thanks very much. So the Strawberry Festival really runs on volunteers and sponsors, and I'd like to thank some of our more senior sponsors now. So our diamond sponsors are the Town of Wishart Stovall and the Stovall Free Press, and they definitely provide us with a ton of support in all kinds of ways. Our gold sponsors, and I'll ask if the platinum and gold sponsors could just meet us over at this picnic table afterwards, and we'll be able to do some photographs. And receive their plaques. So our gold sponsors are Fieldgate Homes, Geranium Corp, Lafarge Canada, Stovall Free Press, and Stovall Toyota Scion. So thanks very much to our gold and platinum sponsors.
And now for one of the most favorite and longest contested it's the pie and jam contest. And this year, first prize winner for the prize was Brittany Clarkson. And Brittany Clarkson is the granddaughter of Gladys Clarkson, who we named this pie baking contest after. Is Brittany here? No. All right, second prize was Dorothy Wagg, and I know Dorothy's here. She won second prize. And third prize is Isaac Shaharadas. I'm sorry if I know I pronounced that wrong, but this is a 9-year-old little boy, and he got the third prize. Is he here? He's actually only 7. All right, the first prize for jam was Sharon Ramacco. She may not be here. The second prize was Leslie Heritage. Is Leslie here?
We know Leslie's. I know Leslie. Congratulations. And the third prize went to Madison Reby. Oh, and here's Madison, another one of our up-and-coming bakers. Sorry, we're going to have the Citizen of the Year, and actually it's Citizens of the Year this year, and I'd like to now present Jim Mason to do that presentation.
Good evening, and a special thank you to the volunteers with our Whitchurch Stovall Strawberry Festival for inviting us all here this evening and for putting on this amazing show for the past 31 years. Thank you all.
I'll be honest.
We are blessed to live in the best country in the world, right here in one of the finest towns in Canada. We're able to freely celebrate the way we will this weekend, rain or shine. We are surrounded by affluence, but not everyone in Whitchurch Stovall can live in a $1 million home. Some can't hold down a job. Some of our neighbors are unable to pay their monthly utility bills. Again, we are fortunate to have several churches, clubs, and other organizations that look out for the needy, our less fortunate neighbors. Your 2015 Whitchurch Stovall Citizens of the Year are those kind of folks. Please welcome, and they're already on the stage with me, this year's recipients, the volunteers of the Whitchurch Stovall Food Bank. For 25 years, these wonderful workers have quietly fed the hungry of our municipality. Yes, it's a silver anniversary for them of getting kids to school with a full stomach, putting food in the cupboards of local residents who can only work seasonally, helping people get through a rough patch in their lives. Every Tuesday, these folks put together hampers, which they hand to clients. More likely their friends. They work out of the Little Churchill Church on the 9th line, midway between Musselman's Lake and Ballantrae. They work out of the limelight in the church basement, sorting and packing food, conducting food drives, collecting donations from boxes in our grocery stores, our schools, and the fire halls. But soon, thanks to our mayor and town council, they'll be moving to the town offices, a more centrally located and potentially busier location, where they will continue the work behind their 25-year legacy. Please join me in congratulating on behalf of the Stovall Sun Tribune and our judging panel, this year's Citizens of the Year from the Whitchurch Stovall Food Bank. And representing the food bank volunteers tonight, it's my honor to introduce Marion Wells.
Good evening.
I am representing the Wichert Stovall Food Bank, and I'd like to introduce my board members to you. On first, it's, will they step forward, please? Diane McIntyre, she's in inventory. Jean Anderson is our corresponding secretary. Joan Doble is our treasurer and inventory. Bonnie Cronin is our statistician, and our Charlotte is our volunteer coordinator. Two members, one is Jean Nauta, and she's in Sweden, and the other gal is Denise Casey, and she's in Temagami, but the rest, those are our board members. To Jim Mason, and the editor of the Sun Tribune, to the members of the selection committee, and to all our friends in the community, it is indeed a great honor to be recognized by the community we have served as volunteers. Our combined effort on behalf of the Wichert Stovall Food Bank are supported and assisted by the many very generous folk that live in this community, for they make it possible for us to deliver a very special, needed charity in our midst. Yes, it's 25 years that the food bank volunteers have been distributing food, giving a listening ear and encouragement in the midst of dark and difficult days for our clients. We are in the process of plans to move from the present location in the Churchill Church to a town facility, and the mayor and the councillors are working to make it happen, and we are surely hoping it will be sooner rather than later. So to all of you who have placed your confidence in our efforts and have voted us this great honor, we say a very sincere thank you to each and every one. And to the Sun Tribune and Jim Mason, we have so appreciated your support through the years. May this little local charity continue to serve the most vulnerable among us with care, concern, and compassion, and it's thanks to each one of you. God bless you. Shalom.
Thank you, Marion. And to congratulate the food bank, some of our local politicians are here to congratulate you as well. First off, the mayor of Wichert Stovall, Justin Altman. Oh, okay, all together. Justin Altman, the mayor. Helena Jazik, our member of provincial parliament. And Paul Calandra, our federal MP. This year's Sports Person of the Year, another award presented by the Sun Tribune. The recipient is Jamie Hewitt, the rugby and boys hockey coach at Stovall District Secondary School. Unfortunately, Jamie is unable to be with us this evening. He's in the United States with his son's lacrosse team. The award will be presented at an awards assembly being arranged at Stovall District Secondary School in October. Thank you for attending tonight. Have a great festival.
Thanks very much, Jim. So we want to be sure that everybody knows that there's all kinds of stuff going on. There's stuff tonight, there's the Giggles Comedy Night, and there's for the kids, there's a movie up at the GO station. All day tomorrow, this stage will be live with musicians and magicians, you name it. So there's no stop activity. This whole area will be the kids' common. There'll be inflatables, birdhouse building, cookies to decorate, all day. and of course the vendors on Main Street and Park Drive. So there's all kinds of activities. Please come out, rain or shine. I want to thank, I said this place runs on volunteers. It does. Our committee members work very hard all through the year to bring this festival together. We have no end of people in red shirts running around helping all kinds of high school students and older high school students. Please do give a round of applause for all the volunteers and committee members who work so hard on this. And finally, if I can just ask those sponsors, the senior sponsors and the and our politicians, if they could move over to this picnic table on my right, and we can present some plaques and also get some photos. Thank you. Have a great festival.
Good night.